Oklahoma State, one of the great teams in wrestling history.
This here is all about my wife, my kids, the life that I live. Through the night, I was his, it was right what I did. My ups and downs, my slips, my falls, my trials and tribulations, my heart, my walls.
What a legacy.
Wrestling fans, you are right in the middle of one of the greatest traditions in all of college sports. This is Gallagher Iba Arena, home of the most dominant athletic team in NCAA history. This program has 34 national championships, 142 individual NCAA wrestling champions, and 462 All-Americans. This is Oklahoma State Cowboy Wrestling! Today, your second-ranked Oklahoma State Cowboys host the third-ranked Iowa Hawkeyes. And let's meet today's lineups. At 125 pounds for the Hawkeyes, Spencer Lee. For the Cowboys, Nick Piccinini! At 133 pounds for the Iowa Hawkeyes, Austin DeSanto. For the Cowboys, Dayton Fix! At 141 for Iowa, Max Murad. For the Cowboys, Kate Brown! At 149 pounds, Pat Lugo for Iowa. For Oklahoma State, Caden Goffeller. At 157 pounds for Iowa, Caleb Young or Jaron Glosser. For Oklahoma State, Wyatt Sheet. At 165, Alex Marinelli for Iowa. For Oklahoma State, Shots Blaylock or Andrew Somers. At 174 pounds, Mitch Bowman for Iowa. For Oklahoma State, Chandler Rogers or Joe Smith. At 184 pounds, Cash Wilkie for the Hawkeyes. For the Cowboys, Jacoby Smith. At 197 for Iowa, Jacob Warner. For Oklahoma State, Preston Weichel. And at heavyweight for the Hawkeyes, Sam Stoll. For Oklahoma State, Derek White. Iowa is coached by Tom Brands. Coach Brands is assisted by Terry Brands and Ryan Morningstar. The Cowboys are led by Alex Deringer, Chris Perry, Zach Esposito, and OSU's all-time victory leader, head coach John Smith!
Rex and Roger back with you. We're about ready to grapple on this Sunday afternoon. Huge crowd, Oklahoma State and Iowa. And again, the majority of the crowd, of course, decked out in Cowboy orange today. And the Cowboys will wear the customary orange singlets today. Hawkeyes will be in their black singlets. Iowa across the right thigh in script, or the left thigh in script. Our referees today, Ryan Hagan will be the main official in the circle here. The big orange mat in GIA with Derek Lark working on their Browder perimeter. 125 pounds, Nick Piccinini. Spencer Lee, and our duel is underway.
Kind of feels like a big duel meet, Rex Holt. Jeez.
Yes, it does.
A little atmosphere.
Around the arena, and yeah, they did have the curtains down in the upper bowl for a while, and they've raised those up as more and more folks have filed in here. Well over 10,000, I'm guessing, and we'll find out later on. But underway at 125, two-on-one arm tie by Spencer Lee. But backing out of that, Nick Piccinini. Nick 26-0, lead 16-1, the defending NCAA champion.
He's also a pinner, got 15 career pins, and he's pinned his last three, I think. And again, he's human. He's only a sophomore, national champion last year, but he hasn't been perfect this year. Nick has been perfect, and these guys could certainly be meeting in a much bigger match in March.
Safe to say that Lee has wrestled fewer matches, but probably the more difficult schedule than Nick Piccinini, who is, for whatever reason, the Cowboys' schedule did not give him a lot of top 10 opponents, but
Dayton Fix made up for it.
Yeah, in on the single leg. Lee gets in on the right leg. Nick trying to do the splits out there now, bouncing on the left leg. Spencer Lee has that left leg picked up, trying to grab the outside leg. Piccinini again pushing on the back of his head, trying to keep him right down there on the end of that right leg on the ankle. Now Lee picks him up, gets him back inside the circle, trying to trip him to the mat. Nick again able to keep that left leg for the moment out of harm's way. Lee trying to kick his hips over the top. Nick now reaches through the crotch as he is over the back of Lee, trying to counter this into a takedown. Lee still hanging on the right leg, but Nick again all the way around behind him now. Has the hands locked through the crotch. Nick has hooked up the leg. And off the edge of the mat, no takedown.
The heck of a job from Nick Piccinini there. Good confidence-building defense. Lee got to the leg pretty easy, but could not finish. You know that's going to give Nick plenty of confidence, which is what he needs against a guy like Spencer Lee. Got to believe you can beat this guy.
No score. 55 seconds remaining in the first period. Then we got the raised stage today, the platform with the orange mat on top of that. As there's Piccinini in on the single leg. They hit the mat. He's got the right ankle picked up. Now hip lock stuck in. Wizard situation where Lee tried to fight off the takedown attempt. Piccinini has that right leg hooked up.
Oh, that was quick. Wow.
They're going to call the stalemate in a hurry.
Both guys have gotten to a leg. Both guys unable to finish. Even Steven.
30 seconds remaining in the first period. No score, both been on their feet.
Remember last year, Nick was in a big hole after the first period. Gave up, 8 points and was the better wrestler the second half of the match. So you got to like his first period here.
High crotch hit by Lee. Piccinini able to scramble out from underneath, grab a leg. Now Nick has the right leg picked up. Can't pick it up. The time runs out. A good scramble to line up the first period. No score.
Yeah, scoreless first period certainly plays into Nick's advantage. After what happened last year, and this crowd's amped already, so you got a sense that, got to feel like Nick feeling pretty good right now.
Not many 0-0 first periods are that fun to watch.
Yeah.
Lots of action, scrambling, and aggressive wrestling, but no score. Here in the second period, Nick Piccinini of the Cowboys will be in the down position.
That's where he got hurt. The Nationals last year went to his back. Eventually got pinned, but got turned numerous times. So, again, both of these guys good on top.
Lee has beaten Piccinini twice in their previous matchups. Nick tried to get out from underneath, got to a leg moment, got his foot on the mat, got to his feet momentarily, but Lee able to drive him back to the mat and off the edge of the mat. We're in the second period, no score. Nick pitching into the Cowboys in the down position. And a little premature movement there, caution. That's going to be on Pitchinetti underneath for moving too soon. On the whistle. Pitchinetti. Trying to a little set out there. Layup high, grabs the wrist, keeping the pressure up top. Now Pitchinetti to his feet. Lee has him around the waist, trying to trip him back to the edge of the mat, down to the mat. They go off the edge once again. 1:17 to go, second period.
And the coach is imploring Nick, pick up the pace, keep moving, keep moving. And Lee's had some issues late in matches. That's why he likes to pin people early. And Nick, again, was the better of the two the second half of that match in Carver-Hawkeye last year, and you sense some momentum building out, even though it's only 0-0.
Nick slowly coming to his feet. Lee reaches through the crotch, now picks up the right leg. Pitchinetti bouncing on the left leg. Lee drives through it. Off the edge of the mat again, John Smith saying, hey, on a stalling call over here. John stomping on the platform. No response from the officials, of course.
Yeah, if you don't think this means anything, just watch the coaches for about 30 seconds because these guys are as into it as the wrestlers are today. First match.
On the whistle. Inside of a minute remaining, second period, scoreless match. Pitchinetti's been ridden for a minute 10 and counting. Nick again. A little set out move underneath. Lee has him around the chest, now cuts him loose. Riding time 1:22 as Nick has the escape. Lee more or less conceded it there after he got to his feet again. 30 seconds remaining in the second period, the two men on their feet. There's Nick, takes a shot in, gets in on the left leg. Hip lock stuck in, Nick rubber arms it, comes out from underneath. 15 seconds to go, now trying to hook up a cradle. Lee, yeah, he's got a cradle hooked up. Takes him to the mat, to his back. 6 seconds to go, there's the fall. Pitchinetti with the fall of Spencer Lee with 5 seconds to go in the period.
Holy cow. Lee got a little careless with that head close to the knee, doing the hurdler stretch right there. Nick locked it up. Gonna at least get the two and then horsed him to his back for a quick pin. And this place just exploded. Boy, that's Darryl Monismith level. Wow.
4:55, the time of the fall. For Nick Pitchinetti, the Cowboys, how about that, leading this duel 6-0. Back in a moment. This is Cowboy Wrestling from Learfield, IMG College.
Cowboy fans, today we're recognizing Ryan Schuyler. Ryan is the Stillwater Otolaryngology Youth Wrestler of the Match. We are joined by Dr. Christopher Goff and Dr. Don Crawley, and they're presenting Ryan with a John Smith signed wrestling headgear. Thank you for your support of Cowboy Wrestling. All right, wrestling, it's time for the Cowboy Wrestling fans to get on your feet and show off your muscles for the Freddie Paul Flex Cam.
Six to nothing Cowboys after Nick Pitchinetti, the redshirt junior, brings the crowd to their feet. A cradle of Spencer Lee coming out from underneath and wind up with the fall.
Yeah, I'm assuming that was Darryl Monismith and Frank Santana decibel level because that was loud. Again, that's why you wrestle them. On paper, Spencer Lee, the champion, had beaten Nick twice, pinned him last year. Nick returns the favor, and boy, talk about a moment.
in this building, in this duel. Not sure we can top it, but here you go. Nathan Fix and Austin DeSanto.
Fix ranked number two in the country, 26-1, a redshirt freshman. DeSanto ranked number three. Sophomore, 16-1. And we're underway at 133 pounds. DeSanto immediately comes charging in, grabs Fix around the back of the head and shoving him toward the edge of the mat. And Dayton hits a little duck under, gets a leg. Now trying to get both legs at the edge of the mat. And not able to scoop the leg up. And now they're off the edge of the mat. No score, but a nice duck there at the edge of the mat, almost a takedown.
Yeah, DeSanto pretty aggressive, but he's also dangerous, kind of like Austin Gomez of Iowa State. He likes to get you coming in and whip overs, can toss you to your back. But again, he's coming in Ramos-like here, very aggressive. And Dayton, as you're taught, boom, drop down to a leg. Uses aggression, nearly got him a takedown.
Listen to that crowd. The Orange Power Chant going on here. Bout number two.
Yeah, they're still a buzz about what happened a few moments ago. Man.
As Roger said, that's a tough act to follow. At least for the Cowboys. Dayton Fix, Austin DeSanto, no score. 1:45 remaining in the first period of scoreless. First period so far. Color ties and pushing and shoving, but that's about it at this point. Little hand fighting going on also.
Yeah, they're letting everybody get their heart rate back down after that explosion. Nicky P, boy.
These two guys have never met, at least on the collegiate level. I don't know, Fargo somewhere, maybe they ran into each other, I don't know, back in the day.
Coach Santo started at Drexel, national qualifier a year ago, and transferred into Iowa.
Texas shot in on the double leg. Fix able to get the hips back at the moment. DeSanto comes up, a little double under situation for a moment, but Nate Fix gets out of that. Drifting toward the near side edge of the bat. 30 seconds remaining in a scoreless first period. There's a shot that kind of underneath by DeSanto. Nothing there to go off the edge of the mat.
Look at DeSanto holding up his fist already. He wants to let the official know that you should be calling stalling here, but a little surprised. I think in Carver Hawkeye, Dayton probably would have been warm enough because DeSanto's certainly the aggressor coming forward. And Dayton certainly not doing a bunch of stalling, but DeSanto shows his physical skills here by kind of pushing Dayton around here in the first period a little bit.
And got a 2-on-1 arm tie at the moment, but nothing going to come of that as the buzzer sounds to end. 0-0 first period.
Scoreless after one at 125, so maybe we'll have a similar result here.
And a man down for the Cowboys again here in period number two. Fitch and Eddie look like he's going to get ridden out in the second period, only to wind up with a cradle and a reverse, a cradle and a fall. Before the second period ended, 5 seconds remaining when that all occurred. Second period here, Dayton fixing the down position. The Cowboy redshirt freshman out of Sand Springs pops to his feet. DeSanto trying to get him back down on the mat. Fix drops a hand down the mat, and it stands back up again. And now it's out with the escape. Fix has a 1-0 lead. Dayton takes a shot in underneath. Good penetration, but almost too good. Kind of shot past the leg. Came out the back door, and we'll try it again. DeSanto out of Exeter, Pennsylvania. As Roger said, began his career at Drexel.
Downtown Philly, so maybe that's in his makeup to kind of be a little loud and aggressive, and those Philly fans certainly like to make a little bit of noise and brash and tough, and DeSanto kind of fits that mold of downtown Philly. Oh, what a firework so far on this one.
Yeah, Dayton's usually the one on the attack, coming forward, mauling his opponent, and he's been a little bit more on his heels so far in this one.
Yeah, I'm really surprised he's not been warned, to be honest with you. Very cautious, that's for sure.
And there's a little over and under situation. DeSanto didn't really try to do anything with it. Fix backs out of there.
Fix in on the single leg, picks it up. They hit the mat. Trying to fight him off. Hands locked around the waist. Fix has both legs. As the time runs out,
there's
OSU
the brick.
Thinking they should have the takedown, and no call by the official. They confer, and now they're going to go to the scorer's table and look it over. Fix had both legs and had his shoulder right in the midriff. And all DeSanto had was the arms locked around the waist.
Looked like two. That's a tough call either way. But again, both legs had him sitting on his rump, and about 95% of a takedown there. But we'll see what happens. Our first of what could be many video reviews today.
When we're done here, we'll have your C-Star Management C-Star of the Day. We got a leader in the clubhouse already. And again, we do that each and every post-game wrap-up. Your C-Star Star of the Day, when you're looking for the right place to call home at the right price in the right location, the most to call C-Star Management. You can call C-Star in Stillwater at 405-377-8740. That's 405-377-8740. Or in Oklahoma City, call C-Star Management at 405-949-1404. That's 405-949-1404. Better yet, check them out on the World Wide Web. C-Star.com. C-Star.com. Or if it's housing around Oklahoma State, LiveByOSU.com. They do not allow the takedown. After watching the review, the official comes out and says no takedown for Dayton Fix. So he's got a 1-0 lead as we go to the final 2 minutes.
Both guys certainly got a rest period there, so no excuse for being tired here in the final 2 minutes. And that hand fighting takes a little bit more out of you than people realize, but, you know, fantastic finish here, I would imagine.
Fix in the top position as we're underway, third period, 133. Dayton gets both legs run in, and now pulls the arm out from under. DeSanto gets him flat on the mat. Fix with that great vine ride, both legs run inside. DeSanto flat on his chest at the moment. Fix working on those wrists, trying to keep him flat on the mat. Has a figure four around the right hip for a moment. Now runs both legs in again. And now cranking on the wrist. And again, trying to keep DeSanto down on the mat. The crowd loving it. DeSanto, of course, rode out on a chunk of that second period right now. Nate Fix running the riding time back in his favor. Up to 28 seconds and counting to go along with a 1-0 lead. Fix again trying to run the leg in on DeSanto. He's kind of hunkered up out there. Fix trying to run that right or left leg in there. He does. Now grabs that left wrist. DeSanto comes to his feet. Fix has him around the waist, gets him back down on the mat. Now a little spiral ride. DeSanto right back to his feet. Fix again. Little crab ride, puts him back on the mat, trying to run the legs in. And now trying to stretch him out and does again. The crowd comes to their feet. Fix. Riding time over a minute. 38 seconds to go, third period. Fix trying to keep him down on the mat again. Still with that leg ride. DeSanto slapping the mat, crawling around. Fix with a figure four around that right hip. Just will not let him get his base under him. 20 seconds to go. DeSanto gets his knees under him. Fix. Both legs run in. DeSanto gets to his feet, now turns into Fix. 10 seconds to go. Dayton still getting the riding time in his favor. Shoots over the top. Locks the man through the crotch. They'll scramble as the time runs out. 140 riding time. Dayton Fix wins it. 2-0.
Just a physical third period right out with the legs. Little influence of Chris Perry right there. And Mike Sheets, and now DeSanto gives him the stare down after getting beat. And Tom Brands gets the crowd going, and we're just getting warmed up, folks.
It's 9-0 Cowboys. Two bounces in, we'll move to 141 after we take a timeout. This is Cowboy Wrestling from Learfield IMG College.
Fans, if you're sitting in the 100 level general admission sections, look behind and under your seat. And if you have the lucky picture of the match, the match's lucky picture is a headshot of senior wrestler Derek White. And if you've got that picture, bring it to section 112 and redeem it for a $5 concession voucher made possible by Sodexo. Please welcome Isaac Smith, who is our Pistol Pete's partner of the match. Isaac will get a free Pistol Pete partner membership courtesy of McDonald's, Stillwater, Perry, and Ponca City. At 141 pounds, coming to the mat for the Hawkeyes, Max Murin. For the Cowboys, ranked 12th in the country, King
Rex Holt along with Roger Moore back with you from Gallagher Arena. Still one of the Cowboys lead the duel over the Iowa Hawkeyes 9-0 as we go to the third battle of the day. Cade Brock out for the Cowboys, 12th ranked redshirt junior, 15-6 on the year, beating 16th ranked Max Murin of redshirt freshman for Iowa at 12-5.
Now you want to keep that momentum going here, Cade, obviously the two-time All-American wrestling at home. And he's been up and down this year, but certainly a match he feels like if he's going to be inside the top 10, this is the guy you've got to beat. Murin, only a freshman. Again, he's got some good wins this year, but he's been inconsistent, as some freshmen are. But again, Cade's got to take care of business. You don't want to let Iowa back in. A nice little duck under from Cade Brock.
And around behind. Got to get him to the mat. Cade picks up the left leg. Still bouncing on the right. Murin has not given it up yet. Now gives up the takedown. Cade tripped the other leg out from under him. Trying to scissor those legs on the way down. Now he'll grab him around the waist and usher him off the edge of the mat.
Yeah, you certainly want to keep that momentum going, the crowd into it. You know, Iowa probably likes their chances at 57, 65, even 74, depending on what happens, but 49 as well. But again, Cade really has to put the pressure on the Hawkeyes right here and take care of business. Good start.
Cade homegrown right here at Stillwater. Cade runs that left leg in on Murin. Got to work on the riding time plot just a little bit. Murin is on his feet. Now stands up. Cade will cut him loose.
Where Cade had 2-1. Had a huge win against Iowa last time the Hawkeyes were in this building when he beat Corey Clark, the eventual champion that year. Remember, Clark had 59 seconds of riding time and Cade won a one-point match. So he's been here and done that against the Hawkeyes.
Murin, out of Ebensburg, Pennsylvania. Cade with a little two-on-one arm tie. Ties up that left arm. Backing out of that is Max Murin. Cade's been the aggressor as usual. Most of the time we see Cade come out hot. Shot and a bad one by Murin. Cade gets the leg. Trying to slip around the outside. Is around the outside. Murin, little hip lock stuck in, trying to fight him off. Cade now trying to turn it into points. Murin shoots the other way, grabs the right ankle of Cade Brock. Got his head on the mat. Cade guys kind of setting up on his left hip, but can't get his leg free, and that'll be a stalemate.
Yeah, good job from Cade. There's Murin, kind of a reshot, got to the legs, got to the hips, but Cade, good counter, showing that foot speed he has. Nearly countered into a takedown, and a good job by Murin forcing the stalemate, but boy, Cade moving well so far in this first period. That's what his career's been based on, that speed, that little pass by he's done so well, and again, his explosiveness when he scores on his feet.
9-0, the Cowboys lead the duel. Third bout of the day, the Cowboys got a fall from Nick Piccinini at 125, defending national champion Spencer Lee, the victim in 455. Dayton Fix, they got an escape in the second period, rode out the third for a 2-0 win. hard fought over Austin DeSanto, number two versus number three. And now we've got a couple of guys just outside the top 10. K-Brock leading 2-1, 5 seconds remaining in the first period. The two men on their feet, but that will be all the scoring in the first 3 minutes.
Yeah. Try not to be a homer. Somebody gave us they're passing out the twos. As opposed to handing out the stalling fist that some other places hand out.
Well, we're all about the takedown. Second period, Cade Brock in the top position. Max Buren of Iowa. Not much movement off the whistle. Kind of braces himself. See what Cade's going to try to do. Cade kind of grabs that left wrist. Now jumps around the right side, a little spiral ride. That right arm up underneath the shoulder, around the chin, left arm back through the crotch. Buren gets to his feet. Cade up to 47 seconds of riding time. Now cuts him loose. Make it 49 seconds of riding time. Score even right now at 2-2. Cade, high crotch. Tried to hit a fireman, didn't get it done, but he still has the leg. Upside down doing a headstand is Buren. Cade hooks the leg and the elbow, trying to roll him over. Boy, they're rolling all over the mat. So far, nobody's got the advantage. And a stalemate call by the official will start them over. Cade Brock. Tied at 2-2, riding time again, holding just 49 seconds there. We're in the second period, 1 minute remaining in period number two.
Yeah, big moments for the Hawkeyes here again. Cade was the better of the two in the first period. You look up and it's 2-2 halfway through the second. And Cade's got to really bear down here and focus.
Cade with 93 career wins at Old State. Hits it again on the single leg. Now hooks the legs and has a takedown. Nice scramble by Cade Brock after hitting that high crotch into the single leg, and now the takedown in a 4-2 lead.
Again, foot speed, boy, an explosive attack from Cade. Finished it off, didn't give a whole lot of time to scramble, but Muren gets a big escape there late in the period, so Cade still got work to do here.
His running time holding now at 102. His lead is 4-3. 12 seconds remaining in the second period.
Cade's got to have confidence he can get to those legs. He's gotten to the legs pretty easy. 100% almost on his shots.
And the time runs out in the second period. Cade Brock has a 1-point lead and 102 riding time. And here in the third period, Cade will be in the down position. Max Buren, we'll see what his game plan is. Try to run the riding time under a minute and let him go. How he's going to play it here in the final 2 minutes. On the whistle. Cade to sit up. Buren has him up around the head. Cade breaks the lock of those hands, turns into him, and has the escape. 5-3 Brock. Riding time holding it. And a double leg takedown for Cade Brock. Right back in, just as Buren relaxed. And now a 7-3 lead. Cade has the leg scissored up. The official's going to stop it, calls potentially dangerous. Cowboy coach is not happy about it.
Yeah, best defense, good offense right there, Rex Holt. Got a 2-point lead. You think he might put on the running shoes. Hadn't been worn yet, but Cade, boom, attacks immediately. Gets to the legs, scores a big takedown, and thinking that could determine the match right there almost.
7-3, riding time back over a minute for Cade Brock. Grabs the left ankle. Now goes up, trying to run the leg in on. And again, the official's going to stop it.
A little early. I mean, he's got the ankle trapped up in there, but somebody's going
to
throw
the. I didn't know that was illegal, though, to trap that. And now Tom Brands is over talking to the official.
Here
through the challenge brick, and he said, you got to call it. John Smith's over there bending the ear on the other side of Ryan Hagan. Both coaches are both barking at the official. Well, we'll see. The coaches are just as intense, as Roger said, as the wrestlers on the mat.
I mean, he stopped it the first time. Potentially dangerous, had that ankle trapped up in there, and he stopped it pretty quick that time and caused the same thing. So an illegal move twice. I guess that should be a point. So that's what Brands is probably arguing here.
Well, they mentioned going to give out the Gallagher Award, but also that we had eight seniors recognized before the duel today on Senior Day. Roger, Johns Blaylock, Zaylin Edwards, don't know him a whole lot, a redshirt senior squadman, again, a workout partner out of Pawhuska, Oklahoma. Mike Magaldo out of New Jersey. Also, you got Jordan Gio Martinez. You have Chandler Rogers, Jacoby Smith, Preston Weigel, and Derek White, all recognized today. They're a good, solid senior class.
Yeah, and those seniors had a big win, all of them, last week at Missouri to pull out that dual meet. Again, that's a pretty good senior class, quite a few All-Americans in there. And, again, you've also got those guys like Magalda, who's been here for 4 years, that gone to the Reno tournament, he's gone to the scuffle, he's won some matches. And, again, those guys are so key to the success of the starters, because someone's got to push those guys every day and say, hey, if you're not ready to go, boom, Christian Ball, boom. Not a senior yet, but he's the guy that gets a call when somebody's injured, can't go at a certain weight class. And against Johns, Blaylock's been a starter. May see him today. Still, no telling what happens over the next hour or so, but they're trying to figure out what's going on with the video review and the illegal hold by Cade Brock.
Video review, the call is confirmed.
Illegal.
Potentially dangerous for the second time.
Yeah, it's just potentially dangerous, so no
illegal hold there.
7-3. Cade Brock's got the lead. The officials telling Cade, let's try not to do that anymore. Off the whistle, Cade gets the first move, grabs that left wrist, pulls it out from underneath, breaks his man down flat on the mat. Cade trying to walk it up toward the head of Max Buren again. Chest flat on the mat as Cade's up to a minute and a half on the riding time clock. Right now, Cowboy fans want a Stoney call. Buren with his chest on the mat. Cade's got his head right in his left armpit. And working on that left arm, the official will stop it again.
What's that call for? That's a little weird.
1:02 remaining in the third period. Cade's got a 7-3 lead and riding time. On the whistle, Murray gets to his feet. Cade picks him up, trying to put him back down on the mat. Does. Grabs the left wrist momentarily. Again, Murray back to his feet. Cade trips him and off the edge of the mat. 51 seconds to go. Cowboys lead the duel 9-0. This is the third bout of the day. Rex Holden and Roger Moore with you from Gallagher Iba Arena. On the whistle, Buren pops to his feet. Cade hanging on him, now cuts him loose. It's 7-3. Cade's got a 1 minute, 59 seconds of riding time. Now shot Buren, gets in on the right leg. Cade with a hip lock stuck in. Out of that wizard situation, picks up that right leg. Buren, Cade bouncing on the left. 25 seconds remaining. Buren kicks that other leg. Cade tries to hit a Granby off the edge of the mat, though, as he's caught for the takedown. And all of a sudden, it's 7-6. Cade has riding time, and that is secure. He cannot lose the riding time. 20 seconds remaining.
Well, you figure Murin would cut him here. Not sure what the strategy is. Murin turn, I guess.
Well, he immediately goes into that spiral top ride, but the time running out on him. Cade just kind of flattens out there. 8 seconds to go. Trying to turn him over. Cade rolls all the way through it. Got caught for a moment on his back, but not long enough as the time runs out. 1:38 the riding time. 8-6. The victory for Cade Brock.
Yeah, they always say sometimes it's not how you start, but it's how you finish. Cade had a great start. They're not the greatest finish, but picks up a huge 8-6 victory, and the Cowboys 3-for-3.
3-for-3, 12-0. The lead for the Cowboys. We'll take a timeout. Back after that, you're listening to Cowboy Wrestling from Learfield IMG College.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the mat, where we're joined by Leroy Smith from the National Wrestling Hall of Fame, the executive director and a former Gallagher Award recipient, along with last year's Gallagher Award recipient, Nick Williams. They are presenting this year's Gallagher Award. The Oklahoma State Wrestling Program is proud to announce former Cowboy wrestler Tadaki Hata as the 2019 recipient of the Gallagher Award, which is presented annually to an OSU alumni who exemplifies the spirit of leadership eminent in the tradition of champions. Hata was a letter winner at Oklahoma State in 1964, 65, and 66, and after an undefeated season, went on to win an NCAA title at 115 pounds in 1965. He won two Big Eight titles for the Cowboys and placed first in the NCAA tournament in his final season with OSU. The former Cowboy was on the U.S. Olympic freestyle team.
After the third bout, as we were told, the Gallagher Award being presented right now to Tadaki Hata. The Japanese wrestlers here, everybody knows Yutaki and Fujita. Here's another guy that made his mark with the Cowboys. One-time national champion, finished third in his senior year. And Tadaki Hata, outstanding wrestler back in the day for Byron Roderick, and then became a great coach, and he's been on numerous freestyle teams. He's coached the Olympic women's teams and things of that nature. So he's had a very illustrious career as a wrestler and as a coach.
You go back and you think about what Byron Roderick did for the University for Wrestling, the Hall of Fame is here. He's responsible for bringing all these Asian Japanese wrestlers from his time as a competitor, traveling the world, Australia at the Olympics, and made relationships with, developed relationships with this whole Japanese organization, and boom, somebody's father said, "Where, if you're going to come to the U.S., where are you going to wrestle?" Boom, probably come to Oklahoma State because they've got a little bit of history, and boom, what an amazing run. Again, another one, a national champion, and you don't give the Gallagher Award out to somebody that was 100-0 and won three national titles and was a wrestler. Guys that contribute to the sport, high school level, junior high level, depending on, there's a million ways to contribute because, again, everybody knows this sport isn't on ESPN every night of the week. They get a couple of days, 3 days, 4 days every March, but the people that hang around the sport after the fact that are successful in business, successful in life, that's a good example as to what this sport can do for a lot of people. And, again, Mr. Hata, again, a very nice man, always has been. They're passing out the twos for all the stuff. Talking about takedowns, certainly another one of those excellent takedown technicians wearing that orange and black.
No doubt, Tadaki Hata, the recipient of 2019 of the Gallagher Award, just presented here as the Cowboys, again, are leading this duel 12-0. Cave Rock just put one, another one, a third straight match in the win column for the home team.
Yeah, everybody's been laughing at me all week when I said, I think OSU can win seven matches, and we're off to a pretty good start. So
you notice I did laugh at you. You tell me if Rooster can pull a freight train, I'm hitching him up, pal.
Of course, you know, like I'm like everybody, I picked Nick to pin Spencer Lee. You know,
well, everybody, sure.
Everybody knew that was going to happen.
Yeah, that was a given. Where was 49, Caden Gefeller for the Cowboys. Ranked number 6 of the country, 24-3. What a year he has had after moving up. An injury, and boy, you talk about seizing an opportunity. Caden Gefeller has done that. His opponent, number 12 ranked man, Pat Lugo, a junior from Iowa, 14-6.
Yeah, Patricio Lugo, former Edinburgh Fighting Scot. Again, he's tough to score, and he's a solid 49-pounder. He's one of those guys hovering around the top 12. Caden, again, he's been a guy wrestling on pace, aggressiveness, ego, attitude, confidence. Last week was probably his worst match this season, I think, against Mahler. He's a good opponent, but Caden certainly was not himself. We'll see what he's got today against a guy that's physical, can really work hard with his tie-ups and hand fighting. He's, again, tough to move, and Caden's going to have to wrestle a smart, tactical match here.
Well, I think we saw him, Roger, with the duel with Air Force where he kind of grabbed his lower rib cage, and he went ahead and finished the match. He didn't think much about it, but apparently lingering effect. There's a single leg. Lugo grabs that left leg upside down over the top, grabbing an ankle is Gefeller. And now the two men facing opposite directions. Gefeller, though, in a more precarious situation, trying to hang on to that left ankle. Now trying to roll through it, got caught on his back. And, yeah, gave up a two-pointer. And it's going to be a neutral two-point. Ball, John Smith threw the brick out there. Now he's going to go retrieve it.
Nope. That was the right call. That's how you're supposed to call it. That's the way that rule was put in, and that was probably the proper call.
Well, Caden Gefeller trying to scramble out of a mess here in the early going as a reversal. So the 2-2 given up to Lugo. Gefeller with a reversal. It's 4-2. And now Johnson into 2-2. They didn't give him the takedown, I do not believe. I think they just gave him the...
It's the neutral two-point near fall.
Nobody had control, but
so
Caden's shoulders were exposed.
A neutral two-point near fall, and then just a takedown for Gefeller. Regardless, it's 2-2. If it's called a takedown or a two-point near fall, which is why they put that rule in there. Guys rolling around, going to their back. They don't want you to go to your back. Got the proper count. Got him a two-pointer, but then you keep wrestling, and Caden scrambled into a two-pointer. So regardless of how it's called, it is 2-2.
And trying to get to his feet is Lugo. Caden Gefeller trying to keep him on the mat, now trying to grab him around the waist as he got to his feet, not able to do so. Lugo turns in, and now it's called, Stoney called, backing off the mat there. But the escape for Lugo, he leads 3-2.
And you see Pat Lugo again, he's adapted to the Iowa style. He's kind of like DeSanto was, he's in your face coming forward and gets the leg again here.
Got the leg, and again Gefeller shoots back over the top, grabs an ankle, same situation we had a moment ago. Gefeller just trying to scramble this thing and turn it into a scramble and maybe come out with some points for himself in the long run, but it was Lugo who initiated the action again, but Gefeller trying to does fight him off as the buzzer sounds in the first period. Three to two. Pat Lugo of Iowa with the lead. We're at 149, fourth bout of the day. Oklahoma State leads the duel over Iowa, 12-0. Gefeller to his feet, now drops underneath, grabs an ankle. Looked like he was going to hit a Gramby, decided to grab the ankle. And now trying to reach up and grab Lugo around the head. Now steps around the backside, hooks the leg. And Lugo's in trouble. It appears, and he is. Reversal. Gefeller now leading it 4-3. Lugo to his feet. Caden cuts him loose. And Lugo takes a shot. Caden tried to counter. Trying to post him to go around behind him after the shot was blocked off. Didn't happen. The two men on their feet. Again, right to the edge of the mat. Rubber arm. That right arm free. And now around behind to grab the ankle. Trying to get the outside leg tied up as they go off the edge of the mat. But the officials saying no control as they're outside the circle.
Good action, though. Boy, both guys kind of a little sloppy, but definitely wrestling hard here.
4-4. And that sounds about right from what we've seen so far. ...48 seconds remaining, second period. Riding time, no factor at the moment. There's Lugo again, got to the leg. He's gotten to that leg almost every time he's shot. Gefeller just trying to scramble every time to stay out of trouble. Back over the top, locks the hands to the crotch, but he's in trouble again and gives up the takedown. 25 seconds to go. Gefeller backing off the edge of the mat, just doesn't quite look himself.
Well, Lugo also in low, compact. Caden a little bit too upright. Lugo, that short stature, has been able to get underneath, get to the hips of Caden a few too many times. But like I said, Rex, Caden just not moving as sharp as we've seen prior to the last 3 weeks.
6-4, Lugo now with the lead. And he's running his riding time right now up to 30 seconds. Caden tried to hit a Gramby. And now gets cradled up after he comes out of that Gramby. Lugo sticks that head right in the right side of the rib cage, trying to cradle him up, not able to lock the hands. Now Gefeller to his feet. And they go off the edge of the mat. Well, not quite. Time runs out in the second period. And Gefeller now trailing 6-4. The riding time is just 49 seconds. In favor of Pat Lugo of Iowa. Again, the Cowboys leading He won the first three, including a unexpected fall for the Cowboys at 125. Third period, final 2 minutes. Gefeller, the top position, but coming to his feet, Lugo. Gefeller cuts him loose at 7-4. And the riding time at the moment is no factor. And there's Lugo right in underneath, goes right in, grabs the left leg off the edge of the mat.
Yeah, Caden carefully getting warned here. He's been warned once, so got to stay in there. See if we can find him a takedown to get back in this thing.
Like I say, it's just been kind of weird, the fact that Lugo's just seemingly gotten the leg every time he's reached for it. Boy, there's that ugly-looking shot, but it works for Gefeller, where he just lays down, grabs the ankle, scoops it up. Lugo back over the top, locks him around the waist. Now Lugo upside down, right on his head, hanging onto that left toe, trying to keep Gefeller from coming out the back door, which he does. Now picks up the left leg. Lugo bouncing on the right. Get trying to get the outside leg, had it momentarily, but couldn't lock it up. Outside the circle, 51 seconds to go. Again, the riding time, not a factor at the moment. 3 points late. Caden Gefeller. 40 seconds remaining. Seconds. Just doesn't appear he's got enough energy to get it done. 20 seconds to go. Lugo and now just playing some defense with a three-point lead. There's a bad shot, kind of reached under there, but no harm, no foul, but only 8 seconds remaining. And Gefeller is going to lose this one. 7-4, the final score, as Pat Lugo upsets Caden Gefeller. And the Hawkeyes are on the board. The score, 12-3.
Yeah, Lugo just the better, I mean, of the two. Again, a veteran. Again, it's an upset on paper, but again, Lugo, again, he's won a lot of matches. But yeah, Caden, certainly not 100%, all of it's physical or mental or both. But again, we've seen him all year long, and the last two matches have not been Caden Gefeller.
Lugo wins it 7-4 over Gefeller. We move to 157 after we take a timeout. This is Cowboy Wrestling from Learfield, IMG College.
Give her a big kiss. Good job. Yeah, way to go. Come on, give her a kiss. Whoa, all right. Big kiss, thank you. Come on, give him a kiss. All right, we got 2-for-1 there. On the mat at 157 pounds, Caleb Young for the Hawkeyes. For the Cowboys, Wyatt.
We move to 157. Oklahoma State leading the Iowa Hawkeyes 12-3. And for the Cowboys here at 157, it'll be Wyatt Sheets. Redshirt sophomore out of Stillwell, 15-9 on the year. The opponent, number 7 ranked Caleb Young of Iowa, a sophomore. 15-3 on the year.
Needless to say, this is Wyatt's biggest match in front of the home crowd, our biggest match, period, as far as the situation and opponent and heavy underdog here.
The official attendance today, 13,811. It is a sellout. 13-8-1-1, shot in underneath. Caleb Young gets in on a single leg. Sheets back over the top. Locks the hands to the crotch. Young has that ankle up over the back of his head. Now picks up the right leg, kicks the other leg out from under White. Sheets and has his takedown. And Sheets immediately out with the escape, and it's 2-1.
Yeah, the Hawkeyes are certainly thinking feet to back or pinning combination of some kind here. They're trying to get back in this duel again. Still plenty of time to go, but this is a huge match for the Hawks. And what the Cowboys do in the next couple of three ways, Wyatt could make it really tough. The Cowboys win this match here, they're going to win the duel running away, I think.
Right now it's 12-3. And this is the halfway point of our duel, 157 bouts. Wyatt Sheets trailing 2-1. Seen White from time to time where he's been aggressive on his feet most of the time.
You know, last week, again, a 6-5 mat, that first period, we had a duck under that was a thing of beauty and awesome technique. That's his go-to shot is that high crotch duck under. And again, that's in the family genes. And he's hanging in here with Caleb Young. Got the initial takedown, did Young, but White certainly not being pushed around here.
Hits that duck under, but blocked off by Young. Has him underhooked under that left shoulder.
This is where you do not want to be. He's killing him in that front headlock. I was made a living off a post in the head and spinning around and countering into a takedown. Good job from Wyatt to back out of there.
30 seconds to go, the two men on their feet. The collar ties. Circling around the middle of the big orange mat. Again, we got the stage out today, the raised platform for the Hawkeyes and the Cowboys, and a sellout crowd on hand. And that'll do it. One period in. And it's Caleb Young leading 2-1 over Wyatt Sheets, weighed 157 pounds.
Yeah, I think anybody that asks, hey, if Wyatt's going to trail 2-1 after the first period, they'd say, yep, I'll take that.
Wide in the top position here in period number two. And on the whistle, that little crab ride situation as Young sets out. Sheets, he'll wind up giving up the escape there. And Young immediately takes a shot after getting his escape point, grabs the left leg, picks it up high in the air. White bouncing on that right leg, in trouble. Young kicks that leg out from under him, has another takedown.
Yeah, I remember Caleb Young, a 74-pounder, 65-pounder. He's made the move down to 57. You can tell, boy, a big, thick, strong 57-pounder right there. That was just, I'm getting to the leg, and I'm going to finish this. Wyatt couldn't do much to stop him.
5-1. Sheets on the whistle as a little set-out maneuver. Now gets to his feet. Young picks him up, elevates him, trips him back down the mat. Sheets immediately hits a little set-out. Young has that left arm around tight waist. Sheets to his feet, locks him around the waist again, takes him off the edge of the mat with 107 to go, second period. Caleb Young of Iowa leading this one by the score of 5-1.
Another Pennsylvania product. All kinds of four Pennsylvanians in their lineup. Kind of a smart move, I think, these days.
On the whistle, Sheets hit a switch, tried to. Blocked off by Young, who drove him back to the mat. Gets him under control. Sheets on his knees, on his base now, sets out again. Young up to 50 seconds now on the riding time clock to go along with that 5-1 lead. Sheets again trying to get those hands unlocked. Gets out with the escape. 59 seconds. On the riding time clock for Young, 5-2 is his lead. 25 seconds to go. White Sheets could really use a takedown as the time runs out here in the second period. 15 seconds. And that looks like that will be it for the second period. There's the buzzer, 5-2, the lead for Caleb Young of Iowa to go along with 59 seconds of riding time.
Wyatt's right in there again. Caleb Young's been as high as number 3-4 in the country this year. Again, Wyatt making a good account of himself here. And again, he's going to be the guy at 57 moving forward. He may be the top seed at the Big 12 championships when all said and done. Big 12 not the deepest at 157. And Wyatt's certainly a wild card when it comes to what he could possibly do in Pittsburgh.
Wyatt in the down position, came to his feet immediately, picked up in the air, put back down on the mat by Caleb Young. And now Sheets is up with the escape. It's 5-3. Riding time holding at 113, but Wyatt Sheets has an opportunity to pull off an upset here against the number 7 ranked man in the country.
Now, Young's pretty much controlled the match throughout, but again, you look up and 2-point match in the third period, Wyatt right in this thing.
120 remaining, the two men on their feet. In the middle of the mat, and now a whistle. And a point for Iowa, hands to the face. And it's 6-3 now. Sheets takes a shot, trying to shoot to the far leg, didn't get it. Oh, and a nice job as he was about to get countered by Young and kind of hit a standing Grammy and got out of it. So no harm, no foul, but inside of a minute remaining, and Sheets is 3 points late right now. And don't forget that Young has riding time sitting at 113. Sheets again, shoot for that far leg and gives up a takedown.
Now, regardless, Rexall, again, Wyatt Sheets got a moral victory in that orange singlet, but again, he's hanging with number 7 for 3 periods. He still feel like he's right in this match. And
well, he's going to work a reversal. Got to his feet, a little switch, able to get around behind. It's 8-5. 18 seconds remaining.
Yeah, again, with more confidence for Wyatt Sheets. I can hang with these guys. It's all about confidence with him, I think. And a good showing here against Caleb Young.
Riding time is secure also for Young. Sheets has got to turn him, but Young is not going to allow that to happen. The time runs out, 103 the riding time, and it's a 9-5 decision for Caleb Young of Iowa.
Yeah, good job. Wyatt Sheets again felt like Caleb Young the better of the two, but again, Wyatt shows right there, third period reversal and right in that match and hands to the face from riding time, and good job, Wyatt Sheets.
Caleb Young with the win, and that's 2 in a row for the Hawkeyes. The Cowboy lead down to 12-6. Back in a moment. This is Cowboy Wrestling from Learfield, IMG College.
Blaming all on my roots, I showed up in boots and ruined your black tie affair. The last one to know, the last one to show, I was the last one you thought you'd see there.
Ladies and gentlemen, today's attendance, 13,811. Thank you for your support of Cowboy Wrestling.
Said, honey, we may be thrilled, but you'll never hear me complain. Cause I got friends in low places where the whiskey drowns and the beer chases my blues away. And I'll be okay. And I'm not big on
salt. Brooks here from the sellout crowd, or to entertain the sellout crowd here at Galgaraba Arena on this Sunday afternoon, treated to some outstanding action so far at the halfway point of our duel today. 5 bouts in. Cowboys leading 12-6. Pokes won the first 3. Iowa's won the last 2 as we move to 165. And for the Hawks, it'll be the number 2 ranked man in the country, Alex Marinelli. He's 19-0 for the Cowboys. It's going to be Johns Blaylock.
Yeah, physical advantage here for Marinelli. He's a big, strong 65-pounder. And
undefeated, second in the country. Blaylock coming up from 157, but he's a senior. And the ghost of Gallagher pass, but again, Marinelli, but he's just tough.
Double leg takedown. Marinelli leads 2-0. And he's going for the downs. He's immediately grabbing that left arm and putting up the knee up around the left ear of Blaylock right out on the head. He's trying to pull that arm out from underneath. A little chicken wing action. And he wants to turn this cowboy over and pin him as soon as possible. And of course, that would tie our duel up. Jots Blaylock out of Berry Hill, one of the seniors recognized before our duel today.
Marinelli kind of, again, as a freshman, kind of a conservative and won a lot of close matches. This year he's really opened up and he's gotten aggressive and he's using that physical skill of his to hammer a lot of people.
Never mentioned that the previous opponent, Young, was out of Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania. Familiar name for the Groundhog fans. Marinelli's out of Miamisburg, Ohio, and he's got Blaylock turned over. Just a quarter Nelson and flipped him over on his back for a moment. Man, the officials are conferring. It's a 2-point near fall. And it's 4-0.
It looked like a three-quarter Nelson, but
right.
Coaching staff was saying, nope, that wasn't a three-quarter, and something was illegal in there. And
there's a stalling warning right underneath now. Wow. Jots Blaylock.
That's a little strange.
And again, right up on the head. Marinelli's going for it. Trying to, again, snake him up. Just trying to snake him up and horse him to his back. Didn't quite get it done. 102 remaining first period. Blaylock getting wrestled 157 this year when he did get some opportunities early. Wrestling at 165 today, but Chandler Rogers not making 165. There's again, snakes him up, takes him to his back. And Blaylock able to roll through it. That's a 4-point near fall. Got off his back.
Say last year he wrestled, remember, Kimmerer. 157 last year, a big underdog, but he battled, only lost 9-2, but Marinelli's a little bit bigger and stronger.
He's going to pin him. That's it. Just took it to his back and pinned him there. And that'll be 2 minutes and 44 seconds, the time of the fall. Again, number two ranked Alex Marinelli goes to 20-0 with another fall for the Hawkeyes, the first of this day. And that'll tie the score up at 12-12 as we move to 174 after we take a timeout. This is Cowboy Wrestling from Learfield, IMG College.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 174 pounds, for the Hawkeyes, Mitch Bowman. For the Cowboys, ranked 10th in the country, Chandler Rogers.
Back with you at Gallagher, Iowa, and we're all tied up at 12-12. Chandler Rogers gets the call for the Cowboys here at 174 pounds. He is 16-2 on the year. And his opponent, Mitch Bowman, 7-4 on the season. Chandler in being aggressive, picks up that left leg. Now goes up around the waist. Bowman's got a hip lock stuck in, a wizard. Situation out with the, but no escape, just didn't get the takedown. John Smith, there's Chandler with the takedown. Smith threw the brick out. He wanted the takedown prior to that. John just says, give it back to me. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you already threw it. You got to go through with it.
He threw the brick, so the official comes over.
Yeah, once you throw the brick, you've got to go
Tom
for it.
Brands comes over and says, hey, yeah.
You can't.
So you got to look at it.
Not throw the brick. John was saying, oh, we got the takedown. Let's forget it. A little bit of excitement in the moment there. Again, Chandler coming up from 65. But he's a former All-American at 174, so he's been up here before. Bowman, 97-pounder, 84-pounder. He's been knocked out of the lineup by a couple of teammates. So he's moved down to 174. Hasn't had a huge impact for the Hawkeyes, but he certainly could here today. And Chandler has had a few big moments in this building. The Cowboys need him here as we, again, after all that, we're tied and starting fresh. And go figure, Rex is going to come down in the last couple of matches. And again, Chandler's got to take care of business here because Chandler Rogers, Joe Smith, whoever was going against Bowman was favored to win. And you can't give up points here. Hands to the face. Yep.
Well, Chandler came back, got the takedown anyway.
Wasn't it hands to the face? Yeah.
And I don't know. He came out and said whatever he said. The official, Ryan Hagan.
I mean, the brick was thrown because of hands to the face. And so that should be one and then the takedown. So. Uh-oh, no more chat. Yep, no more challenges. Maybe it wasn't hands to the face. That's why they're keeping the brick now, because they lost the challenge.
Okay.
Regardless, 2-0.
Chandler leads 2-0. On the whistle, popping to his feet, Bowman. He drops down and grabs the leg. He's got an escape. Trying to work a reversal, not able to do so. He's got a heavy wrap around that left shoulder.
Left leg wrapped as well. This guy's been through the trainer's room a few times, looks like.
Yeah, that's not a sleeve. That looks like that is. Well, there's part sleeve and part tape on that thing, that left leg. Chandler working a two-on-one arm tie, 1:38 remaining in the first period. Chandler Rogers moves up a weight, leading 2-1. Now they go up a body. Chandler going to throw him to his back. He'll get the takedown, trying to keep him on his back, scrambling off his back, Bowman off the edge of the mat. It's 4-1.
I'm going to say, you got to be careful against these bigger guys locking up upper body, but Chandler certainly not backing down, goes double overs. Hop, skip, and a jump puts him on his back momentarily, and again, Chandler always seems to wrestle well with big crowds.
Again, as the man sets out, Chandler trying to jerk him to his back. Now grabs that left arm. Now a little spiral ride. Bowman gets to his feet. Chandler ushers him off the edge of the mat. Chandler, another senior, recognized today on Senior Day. Another homegrown product, graduating from Stillwater High School. One minute remaining in the first period. It's 4-2, Chandler Rogers over Mitch Bowman of Iowa. Duel is tied 12-12. Chandler in on the single leg. Bowman gets his hips back. Chandler laying in underneath there, all stretched out. Can't suck it up. He'll get a stalemate. Combo started over.
Yeah, not quite heavyweights, but again, Chandler getting caught underneath, overextended, getting to that leg. Got to be careful. He's got to use his quickness and his speed. And it's crafty offensive stuff. Just don't try to do horsepower stuff and just power single or power double. We can get in trouble against the bigger guy.
35 seconds to go. There's a point for Chandler Rogers. Hands to the face. 5-2.
Boy, I wonder throughout the history of this rivalry how many hands to the face penalties we would have seen.
Yeah, they just didn't call it till this year. been a point of emphasis for the officials this season. We've seen it a bunch. One time it cost the Cowboys a match. And it's figured in the scoring of a bunch. Time running out in the first period. And it does. Chandler Rogers got a 5-2 lead. Here in the second period, Chandler will be in the down position.
He selects bottom.
It's Mitch Bowman of Iowa, the top position. Chandler's up and out with the escape immediately. 6-2. Sold out crowd, though, wants some fireworks after Iowa got the fall from Alex Marinelli to tie things up here. The Cowboys looking for some fireworks of their own here from Chandler Rogers. There's a shot, though. Bowman gets hit on the single leg. Chandler trying to get his hips down. Get him back. Underneath there, hanging onto that leg is Bowman. Doesn't have a lot of leverage, though, to do anything with it as they're off the edge of the mat. Chandler's got 93 career wins at Oklahoma State. Looking for number 94 today, and the Cowboys need it. Four bouts remaining, including this one. And the duel knotted at 12-12. Both teams with a fall today. A fall and two decisions for each. There's a shot underneath again. Bowman gets into that right leg. Chandler gets his hips back. Stalemate call. One minute. Period number two. The clock continues to roll. Chandler got a little leg sweep there. That didn't work. Chandler missed a huge chunk of the season with an injury. But does appear that Joe Smith's going to go to 65 when you look at the weigh-in charts today. And Chandler may remain at 74. And Jacoby Smith comes down as anticipated. They will battle it out for that spot in the postseason. Shot didn't get there. Bowman, Chandler trying to post him to go around the outside. Didn't do it. 19 seconds to go in the period. And a stalemate call by the official. Again, Ryan Hagan will bring him back to the center of the mat. Riding time, no factor. Chandler Rogers will take a 6-2 lead into the final 2 minutes here at 174 pounds.
Yeah, Bowman's a guy that's, again, maintaining his weight. He's come down a lot. So we'll see what he's got left in the gas tank. And Chandler, of course, weighing at 168 today. So he's, again, just got to take care of business here. You got to like OSU's chances moving forward. But this is a big one here. Chandler's got to come up with a big third period and finish strong as a senior. A little repair work, had to get a needle and thread for.
Well, the thing is, tape is coming unraveled. And there's a caution on Chandler Rogers from the top position before we get the third period underway. Mitch Bowman is down. And down on the scoreboard, 6-2. He said he got to his feet immediately off the whistle. He's up and out. Chandler gives him the escape, and it's 6-3. Tom Brands is up on the stage. There's Chandler with a single. They hit the mat. He's got a takedown. Now he's trying to hook it up. That assassin turned him on his back. And he's got him on his back. And getting a count out of it. Chandler got him hooked up on his back. There's the fall. The fall for Chandler Rogers. And he does a little dance in celebration.
Yeah, that's how you. Finishes a senior right there. Wow. Take a bow, Chandler Rogers.
And he does. And the Cowboys lead it 18-12. How about that? Sports fans back in a moment. This is Cowboy Wrestling from Learfield, IMG College. Crowd still going nuts. After the fall from Chandler Rogers gives the Cowboys an 18-12 lead over the Hawkeyes with 3 bouts remaining when we're done here. We got several candidates for your C-Star Management C-Star of the Day. Chandler Rogers just threw his hat in the ring. And again, when you're looking for some place to live, whether it's in Oklahoma City, Stillwater, or around Oklahoma State University, from luxury homes to all the way to efficiency apartments, everything in between, give them a call at C-Star Management for all your housing needs. Again, in Oklahoma City, Stillwater, around Oklahoma State, visit the websites at livebyosu.com, livebyosu.com, or c-star.com. Sponsor of our C-Star, Star of the Day. C-Star Management, appreciate those folks as we're at it at 184. And Jacoby Smith out for the Cowboys, ranked number 9, 22-3. Made it the 12th ranked man for Iowa, Cash Wilkie, a junior, 17-3.
Yeah, still plenty of work to do, but man, Chandler Rogers, that's how you finish your Gallagher-Iowa Arena career, moving up 174 and in a tight match, a tight duel with the Hawkeyes and your patented move. Well, that's a easy story to write right there for Chandler Rogers. And still big matches here. The next three still going to determine this duel meet.
Jacoby in on a single leg. Picks up the right leg. Wilkie bouncing on the left. Jacoby trying to get him back inside the circle. Has outside leg. Oh, couldn't hold it. Had it for a moment. Now trying to pull the man again back inside the circle. Wilkie sticks in a hip lock, though, and able to get off the edge of the mat. No harm, no foul. And John Smith wanted fleeing the mat.
Yeah, Wilkie, big 84-pounder. Again, he's a 97 moving down. He's a big, thick 84. And, of course, Jacoby, a natural 74, and he's making that move down. What did he weigh today? Jacoby Smith went in at 178.3, so... See what he's got in the gas tank. He's going to need every ounce of it for 7 minutes here because Wilkie can battle. And he's tough and physical and good 84-pounder.
No score. 128 remaining. We are in the first period at 184 pounds. 3 bouts remaining. Oklahoma State and Iowa. Cowboys lead again 18-12. Jacoby, you can tell, just a little smaller, but nobody's stronger than this dude, I promise you. Give it away a little weight, but strength-wise, he'll match up with anybody at this weight. Wilkie, a little front headlock there. Hanging on the head and the shoulder, trying to pull him down to the mat, or just hangs there. Jacoby backs up now. Out at the edge of the mat. Wilkie sticks an underhook under that right shoulder. Has the collar tie. Trying to force Jacoby off the edge of the mat. And the official will stop him and send him back to the center of the mat.
Yeah, classic Iowa right there. Big, powerful, tie you up, get that underhook dug in there, and then a snap down. And then spin around behind you. Made a living off that since the Gable days.
Time running out in a scoreless. First period at 184. Rex Holt and Roger Moore with you. And the buzzer sounds. Period number one in the books. It's 0-0.
Yeah, boy, that's what Chandler Rogers can do at 174 anywhere. I mean, Jacoby Smith, Chandler Rogers, and that's going to be tough questions to answer right there. How do you determine that? 174, but someone's got to go to Tulsa in a couple of weeks.
Jacoby, the down position. 0-0, period number two. Wilkie hooks up that left ankle. Jacoby gets to his feet. And he's out with the escape. One to nothing, Jacoby Smith with a lead. And he's got a single leg picked up, spins Wilkie to the mat, and has the takedown. Explosive takedown, Jacoby Smith. Wilkie to his feet, Jacoby takes him off the edge of the mat. 3-0, Jacoby Smith with the lead.
Yeah, we saw him beat guys up at 184 with that quickness, that foot speed. A lot of power down at 174, a lot of those upper body ties. These put guys on their back right there. It was a combination of that speed and that power, which makes Jacoby so dangerous at 174. Put both of them in the bracket. They both finished top eight.
On the whistle, Jacoby grabs that left ankle momentarily. Wilkie to his feet. Jacoby cuts him loose. It's 3-1. 1:15 to go, second period. The two men on their feet in the middle of the mat. Jacoby Smith out of Muskogee. Red shirt senior for the Cowboys. There's a stalling warning on Wilkie. Jacoby has been the aggressor. ...45 seconds remaining in the second period. 184 pounds. Long range shot, but nothing there for Wilkie. Time winding down. Second period, 25 seconds remaining. Seconds. Jacoby takes a long range shot, didn't get there, and comes up with a 2-on-1 arm tie, but that'll run out the second period. Jacoby Smith has a 3-1 lead as we go to the final 2 minutes here at 184. It will be Cash Wilkie of Iowa in the down position.
There you go. Third period to determine this match. See what Jacoby's strategy is, but you know Wilkie's going to charge. Of course, he's the only man that's been warned, so. Jacoby can work it.
Caution.
Period.
That's on Wilkie from that bottom position, moving too soon. And there's another caution on the bottom man, Mr. Cash Wilkie.
You got to figure Jacoby's going to cut him anyway, so I'm not what his hurry is here.
Jacoby grabs the ankle off the whistle, hangs on it for a while, and gives it up, gives up the escape, and it's 3-2. Riding time, no factor. Jacoby, far leg, comes up with the right leg. Wilkie trying to fight him off. Jacoby with that quickness, able to get that right leg scooped up. Now got to get him to the mat. Bouncing on the left leg, little hip lock stuck in. Jacoby spins him to the mat, has the takedown. Got both legs tied up and leads now 5-2.
That's how you do it. As we said earlier in the duel, the best defense is often a good offense. Jacoby on the attack, got to the single leg, and again, used his foot speed to get to the leg and then showed that power for the finish. That's a deadly combination and a big third period takedown for Jacoby.
On the whistle, Wilkie. Slowly comes to his feet. Jacoby hangs on him, cuts him loose. It's 5-3, though. Still not out of the woods by a long shot with 1:10 remaining here in the third period. There's another shot by Jacoby. Gets in on that right leg. And hands to the face. Called on the Iowa wrestler, Wilkie. That's a point for Jacoby, 6-3. Jacoby got to that leg and took a shot in the face from Wilkie, but still gets the 1 point penalty point. But another good shot by Jacoby as he got to that leg again. Now Wilkie's got a leg. Turns and grabs that right leg. Jacoby turns, trying to kick his way out from underneath. Now scrambling, gets to the edge of the mat, doing the splits over there, trying to keep that left leg out of harm's way. And they're going to call Jacoby for stalling. We're getting off the edge of the mat.
Yeah, probably the right call there, Jacoby. And he had one to play with there.
6-3, Jacoby with the lead. 30 seconds remaining, the two men on their feet. Jacoby goes up top, underhook under that left shoulder. They're side by side on the mat. Jacoby reaches underneath, grabs an ankle. Wilkie still with that overhook over the left shoulder. Now tries to hit a fireman. Jacoby blocks him around the outside, around behind. Has the ankle. Has both ankles. Has a takedown. Nope. Gonna wave it off. Gonna wave it off. He had both ankles for a moment. But it doesn't matter. The time will run out. No riding time. And Jacoby Smith, a winner, 6-3.
Yeah, good, tough win for Jacoby Smith. Again, up at 84 against a big, physical, tough opponent. He's going to be a beast down at 174, that's for sure, if he gets there. And wow, a couple of seniors back-to-back may have secured the dual victory for the Pokes.
It's 21-12. Mathematically, not out of the woods yet, but looking good. Here are the Cowboys with two bouts remaining. Jacoby Smith, a 6-3 win. The Cowboys, a 21-12 lead. Back in a moment. This is Cowboy Wrestling from Learfield, IMG College.
Time for me to recognize what all my ancestors and just all African Americans have did to set me up to be in the positions that I'm in now. Not just me, but all African Americans. It's kind of a good time of the month to just sit and think about the people, your ancestors, and just be thankful. You know, I look up to my parents very much. I mean, he didn't graduate from college. I think that was his only semester he went. So, I mean, he motivated me to know that, I mean, going through college with a kid like I have, like he did, I mean, anything is possible. It'll be pretty important for me to get my degree and have a kid like he did and then keep getting extra things on top of what he did. He always told me as I was a little kid to be, I always say I wanted to be just like my dad, and he always would get mad at me and tell me, you don't want to be like me, you need to be better than me. So that's what I'm striving for.
Rex and Roger back with you from Gallagher Iba Arena in Stillwater. Oklahoma State leading Iowa 21-12 with two matches remaining. Preston Weigel here at 197 pounds. It's the back of the Cowboys, ranked number six in the country. The redshirt senior 6-0. Missed a whole chunk of the season because of injury. He'll be taking on the number four ranked man of the country, a redshirt freshman, Jacob Warner, for the Hawkeyes, 14-2 on the year.
Another one of those matches you want to see. Obviously, Warner ranked fourth in the country, just a freshman. He went over Miklas, that duel early in the year, and he's again a world-level freestyle guy. Lots of credentials, and then you got Preston Weigel, who's been off the mat for most of his senior year. A couple of wins, had a big win last week. And again, if Weigel can beat Warner today, then boom, you got to rank him inside the top five or top six in the country, which gives him a seed, most likely, at the national tournament. Has not having enough matches, of course, but again, big matchup here for Preston Weigel. Cowboys could secure the dual meet, obviously, with a win here as well.
And the crowd, again, making their presence felt. A sold-out crowd today, 13,811. 13,811 watching the Cowboys and the Hawkeyes meet for the 53rd time.
And they've been here to do a dandy again.
Weigel on the single leg. Has that left leg. Picks it up. Dumps his man to his rear end. Gets the takedown. And off the edge of the mat. Weigel with that wrap around the right leg that's been troublesome last couple of years. Out of Russell, Kansas. And that's in the country. Went yeah, through Russell, Kansas, and that's the wide open spaces. Weigel called for big too aggressive out of that set position. So
yeah, Hayes, Kansas is out there. Preston's
right.
And Russell's. We call it a suburb of Hayes, obviously, but yeah, that's kind of the middle of next stop, Denver.
And as I understand, he plans to go back and be a farmer and all that good stuff. Good for him. Now the Cowboys need to win right now. A little Crab Riders are back to action. Warner. Again, the Crab Ride continues. Weigel's so good, of course, with a top position. Gets his man off the edge of the mat. Two to nothing, Weigel on top. First period action. And almost halfway, almost at the halfway mark of the first period. And right there we are, 1:30 remaining. Warner back to his feet. Weigel hanging on him. And now Weigel called for stalling as they go off the edge of the mat.
Brands was in his ear, and that's probably the right call. Pressing a little bit too aggressive, trying to work him towards the edge once he gets to his feet. Two times in a row, that's called. Probably this official's done a good job today. Nothing crazy.
Off the whistle. Again, going to that Crab Ride position. Weigel hooks that right wrist, rolls his man back underneath him. Again, this is where Preston can be so, so tough. From that top position, this grinds you into the mat. His riding time up to 50 seconds. Picks his man up high, Warner back to the mat.
Crowd loves that. That's a big, powerful lift, which requires strength in your legs and your hips and your knees, which is good to see from Preston Weigel.
101 the riding time already for Weigel to go along with a 2-0 lead. 52 seconds remaining here in the first period.
Yeah, this is the guy people don't want to see in that bracket, randomly drawn in, that's for sure.
On the whistle. Warner slowly comes to his feet. He's out with the escape. Weigel hung on him for a moment. Gives up the escape. It's 2-1. Preston Weigel, a riding time, holding at 110. 35 seconds remaining. Weigel took another shot. Got good penetration. Now picking up that right leg is Warner. High in the air, trying to kick the other leg out from under. Doesn't get both legs. Now has both ankles. But still no takedown. And off the edge of the mat.
Now you see Warner attacking that right leg. Be careful, boy. You don't want to get crazy and rather you give up two than end your season right here. Don't get that knee all twisted up.
Good shot by Warner. His best opportunity. Weigel a good job to scramble out of trouble there. That looks like that'll be the final salvo fired here in the first period. Weigel with a 2-1 lead.
And Warner looks at his coach and says, I'm going down. I'm choosing down here emphatically. So careful what you wish for. See if Preston can put together something for a turn maybe.
Warner out of Tolono, Illinois. Preston Weigel already with 110 riding time in that top position. Off the whistle, a little spiral ride action. Coming to his feet is Warner. Weigel kind of hanging on him as he comes to his feet. And they're trying to pick him up and put him back on the mat. He does put him back on the mat outside the circle. 1:43 to go, second period. Preston Weigel, only 6 matches this year. But he's won them all. All of the whistle, a little tied waist initially. It gets up high up in the back of the head of his opponent, trying to keep that pressure up top. A little spiral ride action here as his opponent, Warner, does come to his feet. Now a little set out, little crab ride situation. Halatan's call. Forthcoming on Weigel, and that'll be a point. Cowboys have no more challenges, so the locked hands call will make it 2-2.
Now that's where that extra side official comes in handy. Official's back behind the two wrestlers. He can see the hands locked there, and official did the project, pointed at his assistant, said, hey, you got it? And boom, he said, yep, that's locked hands.
So both wrestlers getting a little of a break, a little bit of a break here. John Smith talking to the main official, but I think it was the outside official, Derek Lark, who initially called the locked hands. So it's 2-2 on the scoreboard.
Yep. Got to get
a warning against the Cowboy bench. So Weigel, 1:25 to go, second period. Another whistle, a little tideways, gets his band down on the mat. Now gets to his feet. Weigel rides him off the edge of the mat.
Be careful there. Kind of pushed him off again there, Preston.
Lots 2-2 the score.
Stop and start, stop and start, stop and start here.
Riding time holding it 1:54. Oh, the whistle. Again, a little spiral ride. Getting to his feet, Warner. Weigel picks him up, puts him on the mat, trying to turn him and get some back points out of it. Had him headed that way, but not quite. And again, off the edge of the mat. Riding time over 2 minutes. 1:02 remaining in the second period. On the whistle, Weigel. And spiral right, stuck a half in over the right side as they rolled around the mat there. Now getting to his feet again is Warner. Weigel's already been warned.
And there it
is. And there's another stalling call, and that'll be a point as they're off the edge of the mat. John Smith stomping his foot, barking. Will do him no good. It's 3-2. Off the whistle, Warner to his feet. Weigel puts him back down on the mat. He grabs that left arm. Warner trying to turn back into him. Weigel continues to ride there. Again, a little spiral ride up high. Warner to his feet, back down to the mat. Riding him off the edge of the mat with 26 seconds to go, second period. Preston Weigel riding time to 2:44. But he trails now on the scoreboard after two penalty points. 3-2. And Weigel moved too soon from the top. There's a caution. Looks over John Smith. John says, well, calm down. All on the whistle. Again, Warner to his feet. Weigel has the wrist, edge of the mat.
Gonna get warned again. You gotta let him go.
15 seconds. Trying to get him back down on the mat and does. Little crab ride situation. Now gets control of him off the edge of the mat. 6 seconds. 6 seconds remaining in the second period.
Well, I really thought he was gonna get warned there.
Yeah.
Standing up a little bit too long. He's already. Well, you figured Preston with a takedown in the first period and then a right out in the second will be leading, but he should have a couple penalty points here in the second. And trailing 3-2.
And certainly doesn't want to give up an escape point here in the last seconds. 3 seconds. Weigel pits him up, puts him on the mat, rides out the rest of the second period.
Yeah, riding time. So we're tied 3-3. Yeah, riding time's not going anywhere. We'll ride out for the second, but Preston certainly get an escape. Give him a lead, but. It's going to be a big third period here. This is big for Preston as far as, again, seedings, rankings, confidence. You know the Hawkeyes aren't going to quit. They're going to wrestle 10 matches no matter what the score is.
Weigel in the down position. Final 2 minutes at 197 pounds of Cowboy Senior. Popped to his feet immediately. Got to the edge of the mat, off the edge of the mat. Again, as Roger said, the riding time secure. Over 3 minutes on the riding time clock, so for all practical purposes, we're knotted at 3-3. Off the whistle, Weigel. Very methodical, just kind of waited to see what Warner was going to do on top.
Coach Press has also been warned. Another warning underneath here. We've got to stay active.
Little spiral ride there from Warner. Weigel's got his knees under. Still with that spiral ride. Preston takes a glance at the Cowboy bench. .110 remaining third period. Warner again continue that spiral ride. Weigel almost went to his feet, but now he does a little set out. Works it into a reversal. Preston Weigel leading 4-3. Warner to his feet. Weigel picks him up, puts him back down on the mat.
He's biding his time. Oh, that was an explosive switch right there. Preston about ready to get Warner, looked like. And boom, that's an old classic switch. Use those strong hips, those long, powerful arms. And big reversal for Preston right there. Crowd really, really seems to like that.
Warner gets to his base. Weigel, that tight waist, gets him flat on the mat. 32 seconds remaining. Zach Esposito, John Smith, very animated all match long and barking out information to Preston Weigel, the Cowboys senior. A win here seals the dual victory for the Cowboys. Warner to his feet. Weigel puts him back down again. Got that tight waist. 25 seconds to go. Weigel leads 4-3. Riding time secure for the Cowboy. Now they need to set back. Little crab ride situation. Get a reversal. Weigel trying to turn him on his back. He exposed him for just a brief moment, then got off his own back. 4 seconds. 2-1. 3:10 riding time. 5-3. A victory for Preston Weigel.
I think the crowd will let you know.
And that puts the dual victory away for the Cowboys. 5-3 final. The Pokes now lead it 24-12 with one match remaining. Back in a moment. This is Cowboy Wrestling from Learfield, IMG College.
Ladies and gentlemen, please turn your attention to the video board for the finals of the Cowboy Wrestling Takedown Challenge.
Rex Hilton, Roger Moore, back with you from Gallagher Iver Arena at Stillwater, Oklahoma State. We'll go to 15-0 on the regular season. In the regular season finale today here at Gallagher Iver Arena in front of a sold-out crowd. 13,811.
And seventh consecutive.
And the Cowboys.
Come and join us. Remember to buy tickets.
Now trying to
at the BOK
wrap it up with a win at heavyweight. Derek White out for the Pokes at 23-1. The redshirt senior ranked number 2 in the country. Taking on the 8th-ranked man from Iowa, Sam Stoll, a senior, 8-2.
Yeah, nothing but pride, ego, seedings, rankings. Derek again, Chandler Rogers, senior. Jacoby Smith, senior. Preston Weigel, senior. Derek White, senior. See Derek finish off strong here. His final opportunity to wrestle in front of this big crowd. Very energetic crowd. A reason to cheer today.
Stoll goes about 276 as of the weigh-in today. Derek was around 244, I believe, on the weigh-in today, and normally where he's at. 241 to 245, somewhere in that vicinity.
And Stoll looks like the guy you're going to see when you walk into Willie's. You don't want to start any guff because this is the guy that's going to escort you out of the place.
Sam Stoll, he's out of Minnesota. Kaysen, Minnesota.
He's had all kinds of injury issues again. Well, like Preston Weigel a few years ago at the national tournament, injured and had to default out. He's battled again this year. He started the year ranked number one with what was returning before we knew anything about Gable Stevenson of Minnesota, but he's had a couple of losses. Had lost to Hilger of Wisconsin. Heavyweight, again, a pretty wide open weight class after Gable Stevenson this year. Of course, Derek number two. He beat Kassar of Penn State, but this will be a big win for Derek. Again, the situation, the environment against a veteran, savvy, tough heavyweight.
And again, a guy with about a 30-pound weight advantage to boot. But that's never seemed to be an issue. Derek is plenty strong. All about leverage, not letting that weight matter. Derek's been good at that, shooting from certain angles. He's wrestled a lot of guys this year that have outweighed him. Nothing happening here. Little leaning. Clock rolling halfway through the first period, but off to a slow start here at heavyweight. Cowboys again have wrapped up the duel. 44 to 12, your score, pending the outcome here. Iowa's first loss of the year. They'll leave town 14-1. Cowboys will close out the regular season 15-0, get ready for the Big 12 championships in Tulsa. March 9th through the 10th, tickets still available for that. The BOK Center. Nationals in Pittsburgh, March 21st through the 23rd. Not much happening here with the heavyweights. Leaning, collar ties, and that's been about it, a little hand fighting. And underneath a duck, Derek has the left leg. Stoll trying to get off the edge of the mat, he cannot. Derek gets him around the waist, scores his takedown, and leads it 2-0.
Yeah, we talked about Jacoby Smith against those bigger, stronger guys. Using that foot speed, that quickness. Derek White, not small by any stretch of the imagination, but right there, boy, that's all foot speed. That little duck under, get big Sam Stoll off balance and spin around the outside with that beautiful takedown. And even better, there's only 6 seconds left in the opening period.
And Stoll. Not going to get to his feet. The time will run out. It'll be a 2-0 lead for Derek White as we go to the second period at heavyweight. Derek out of Edmond North High School. Came in from Nebraska as a 97-pounder. Going out as a premier heavyweight. On the whistle. Derek gets to his feet. And Stoll just runs him right off the edge of the mat. Derek looks at the referee and says something. The referee talking right back to him, Ryan Hagen.
Yeah, Stoll's got a little bit of George the Animal steel in him, looks like. Bald head.
Again, to his feet. Stoll takes him right off the edge of the mat. Derek's holding his arms out like, hey, he's taking me off the mat. The officials don't like it when you show them up, though. So the referee kind of shaking his head. Derek, this time, just stays on his knees. The Stoll's moving him toward the edge again, scooting him along the mat. Derek just trots back to the center. The mat says nothing that time, but 1:42 to go, second period. Derek White with a 2-0 lead.
All that pressure that Stoll's putting on, that's going to do a possibly a little standing switch or Derrick can take advantage of that pressure that Stoll's putting on him.
Derrick gets to his feet. Stoll, that spiral ride off the edge of the mat. Far side edge every time so far. Derrick gets to his feet. Stoll just runs him right off the edge of the mat. .133 to go, second period. Derrick on one knee. Stoll again stays right underneath those armpits, moving him. Derrick gets to his feet off the edge of the mat. Crowd's had enough of it. Stoll not. Giving any indication that he's doing anything wrong, just right back on top. And there's a caution on Derrick White, moving too soon from that bottom position. Derrick White, 246.9. It was a little heavier today. Stoll was 276.2. On the whistle, Derrick sets out this time, gets to his feet. Stoll trying to get him off the edge of the mat. Derrick trying to break the line. There's a stalling call on Stoll as he takes him off the edge of the mat again with 108 to go. Second period. Crowd is into it. Final bout of the day. The Cowboys already have the duel in the win column. Derrick White to his feet. Stoll again hanging off the right side, a spiral ride. Whistled by the official and back to the center of the mat. 53 seconds to go here in the second period.
We're averaging about, 15 seconds per stop and start.
Crowd trying to inspire the Cowboys senior heavyweight. There's a caution on the top man. Stoll moving too soon. Sellout crowd on hand today at Gallagher Iba Arena. Oklahoma State and Iowa, the 53rd meeting. On the whistle, Derrick to his feet. Stoll trying to hang on. Derrick trying to spin back inside the circle. Now turns in, Twin gets his escape. And leads it 3-0. Stoll had just gone over a minute in riding time at 105 as Derrick White escapes to make it 3-0. 25 seconds remaining in the second period. The two heavyweights on their feet. Stoll goes upper body, locks the hands around the back. Over and under, the hands are locked. Derrick White just hunkered over there. Said, not going to allow him to get any leverage to try to do anything with that. And the time will run out in the second period. Derrick White's got himself a 3-0 lead as we go to the final 2 minutes. Stoll looks at his bench, his corner. They say go down here in the third period. Final 2 minutes at heavyweight, the final 2 minutes of our duel today. And there's a caution on Derrick White.
What is this guy doing?
Turn off the music thing, hear the whistle.
Back at it. Stoll gets to his feet. Derrick says, well, I'll escort you off the edge of the mat. How about that? Well, he didn't. Unlocks the hands after the riding time, went back under the 1 minute mark at 57 seconds. Derrick White gives up the escape and it's 3-1. 3-1, Derrick White. third period, the two heavyweights on their feet. Here at GIA. Stull has really not had one offensive shot the entire match. Derek White hit a little duck over there at the edge of the mat. That didn't work. They go off the edge.
Good strategy right there. As you know, Stull's going to try to work for a couple of push-outs. And again, he's not going to attack the legs. He's going to leverage moves or something Mako used to do a little bit. But again, Stull's not going to do a sweep single here. Derek's just got to stay in there and hang tough. Has not been warned, so he can put on his track shoes a little bit.
Inside of a minute, third period, inside of 50 seconds right now. Hits another duck. Does Derek White.
That's the danger there. You get trapped underneath, you don't complete it, and that front headlock, that snap down, you kind of allow Big Stoll to catch you underneath there, so Derek's got to be quick.
41 seconds remaining. Derek's got a 3-1 lead. Right now, the running time is no factor. Derek got that takedown with 6 seconds remaining in the first period. And that's the difference right now with 20 seconds remaining. Crowd going to help him bring it on home. And that'll do it. No riding time. And Derek White wins the heavyweight matchup by the score of 3-1. Cowboys, Roger Moore said they would win 7 bouts today. They do. And the final score, 27-12.
Yeah, Nikki P has kind of set the tone all year long, picking up big victories at 125, but to start the duel off today with this crowd, with this atmosphere, the situation, the Penn Spencer lead, talk about setting the tone. From that point forward, the Cowboys, just a better team overall. I mean, a great duel meet. The Penn at 174, certainly the nail in the coffin for the Hawkeyes, but up and down the lineup, the Cowboys competed hard, easily could have 1-8 almost, a couple of close losses, but boy, what an atmosphere, what a day. The Cowboys beat the Hawkeyes, and can either of these teams beat Penn State? Who cares? Today was a fun day, a great dual meet, good for the sport, a lot of fun, a lot of excitement. And congratulations to those seniors. Those last four weights, those four seniors brought it home.
That they did on senior day. The Cowboys win the duel 27-12. They go to 15-0. And that'll be their record for the regular season, 15-0. Iowa falls to 14-1. We'll come back, start to wrap things up in Gallagher, Iowa Arena after we take this timeout. This is Cowboy Wrestling from Learfield IMG College.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Be sure you go over to Allie Reynolds Stadium and see Cowboy Baseball. Thank you for the sellout crowd, 13,811. You guys are awesome.